Hi, my name is Michael Rembacz, and I'm the manufacturing and machining instructor at Concordia University. I work in the mechanical, industrial, and aerospace engineering department, and I'm teaching a course called MIAE 311. The course really allows our students to develop skills in learning how things can be made. And as engineers, we're often designing components, but more critically, we need to be able to design with understanding how things can be made. So there are certain limitations, and this really helps the students grasp these concepts.
The dial on the front of the machine indicates the spindle RPM. To change the speed, turn the handle adjacent to the dial, and it will display the speed you have selected.
Our lectures are given over Zoom, and we have an incredible attendance rate, which is wonderful, and lots of participation from our students. We have active questions, whether students are, you know, raising their hand in Zoom and actually asking the question verbally, or they're writing their answers or their questions in the chat, and our TAs are actually monitoring. I have two wonderful teaching assistants this summer, and they're helping out immensely with our support in our lectures and our tutorial sessions as well. Our lectures are recorded, so all of these recordings are available again on Moodle, so if a student misses a part of lecture or they wanted to come back and revisit a topic that they didn't quite understand, they can always rewatch their lectures at a later time. We've integrated some really incredible assignments and projects this summer. One being, it's a first ever, we actually have our undergraduate students in MIAE 311 develop a CNC, that's computer numerically controlled program for a milling machine. So the students have actually taken this one component that they've started with at the beginning of the semester. They've developed a technical drawing, they're developing a process plan, and now they're gonna go ahead and create a computer-aided manufacturing program that can be run on one of our milling machines at the university. In addition to a large database of videos that we've posted on Moodle, whether it's from YouTube or some videos that we've created at the university for our laboratories, I'm also doing something called live machining. I'm fortunate enough to have a hobby here at home whereby I have some similar machines, albeit a lot smaller than we have at the university, but at least we can showcase to the students in a live way how things can be made. So they're still getting that practical hands-on sense whereby I can voice over as I'm making some components, and they can ask questions, we can stop along the way, and they get a really good understanding of how these components are made. Another main advantage of having a small hobby at home is I have quite a few of these tools that I can showcase and show to the students. I've set myself here at home with an overhead lamp, and I put my phone right on top of that lamp so that I can really showcase to the students what the tools are. I'm also using that for my problem solving, so I can actually write out my problem solving and the students will see it live on their screen on Zoom. So it really feels like you're in front of somebody as they're solving the problem. And we can talk about, you know, how a face mill has, you know, number of cutting edges and the rake geometry, different tool holders, end milling cutters, you know, whatever I can show them, different saw blades, anything that can really correlate to the material. And I can show them right here on the desk. That this overhead view that we're doing allows us to get some really good detail, because I have a magnifying lens on my lamp, so we can get in nice and close to a really small cutter and we can showcase the details and explain them to the students quite easily. Because of this online nature, we become very accessible to our students. Our office hours can be anywhere because we're all more or less in the same place. So it's just a matter of scheduling through Zoom. I typically hold my office hours twice per week for an hour each session. But if a student can't make it to those specific times, we'll schedule a time that works for both of us. Communication with the TAs has been incredible, and between my teaching assistants and myself, the students have a wealth of information at their disposal to really help them through their assignments, their quizzes, their midterms, and preparing for their final exam. I hope to see you all in a future semester of MIAE 311, and together we can unravel all the different intricacies of manufacturing processes for whatever component you can think of. We'll see you soon.